So this is my Exceed RC Sunfire buggy that is kind of not in the best shape in the world. So these tires are actually worse than they look, barely feel any tread on them. Shocks are kind of terrible. This shock shaft is bent. This drive shaft is bent. The body is broken, and the little fan inside is mostly broken. And the diffs are terrible. And I don't love the colors, and I don't really like the bright green on the wing or on the rims. But we got some new parts. Got a full new set of wheels and a brand new motor. And we got diff fluid, shock oil, bearing grease, WD-40 for anything else, and some new front shocks. These are actual Traxxas ones, but this part is covered in oil, so that'll be fun to clean. Some Sharpie markers for the body. And spray paint for the wing. So first we're gonna swap out some of the colors on the body and the wing. Now for the wing, I'm just gonna spray paint it red, and the body I'm going to make this blue kind of reddish. So first we have to take off some stickers and then we can paint it. All the stickers are off. Now let's go paint. So we still have to get the bottom, but that's good for now. So while that wing is drying, we're going to use some little markers to try and make some of this blue like a dark red, and maybe some of the white too. Hopefully it looks cool. Also, I'm going to pull off the nose right here and try and retape that, maybe use some glue because it's falling off. So first I have to take off all the stickers, which there's quite a few of them on here. So yeah. So I'm done with the body and the wing. I wasn't originally gonna do this much, but I did, and honestly, I think it looks kind of cool. In my opinion, I mean, you can hate it if you want, but that's okay. The wing, it doesn't look the best because it was windy and I had to do it up close and everything. And yeah, so that didn't work the most amazingly. The only problem with this is that if it gets scratched, all that's gonna come off because I literally just drew it on the outside. Same with that paint, but that's okay. It looks cool for now. So right now I'm trying to get this piece off right here, and I unscrewed it all in the front, but I have to get to those the two little screws in the back there. Right there, those screws. But I'm not entirely sure how to take this back part off, so that will be interesting. So I've just spent the last couple of hours.
Okay, hours might be a slight exaggeration.
Trying to get out this screw, because that's pretty stripped out now, and I'm pretty sure there's like Loctite or something on it because it wasn't the other one. The other one came out fine, but I thought that I needed to take that one out in order to actually take this apart, but I don't think I do because I got this off, and it's kind of weird, but this little tiny thing goes on the end of that rod right there, and you have to just pop that off, but it's super hard. So then I took this off, so now I can get to those screws. So I think I can still take it apart. So now this little part can come off, and this little thing can come off. So now I think I can get to the rest of it pretty well. So these bearings are crazy dirty. Yep, where's the camera? There it is. So yeah, they're crazy dirty. There's been like rings of dirt in them. So I have to clean those out, and then I'll hit those with WD-40, maybe, and then I will also re-grease those. So I got this back together. It was very difficult because this one's weird and it's harder to put back together than normal ones. And then I got other grease on there around the outside. So now I basically have to put these back on. And then throw it back in the car. So, I have to put it back in here. This is the diff housing. Make sure that it turns smoothly. It does. It sounds a little bit cruddy, but that's just from a little bit of dirt in there. So, that'll get pushed out in a little while. Got that back together. So, now, while this is out, and gotta find a safe place for all this stuff to go. Thank you. That's safe. So now I have to replace the motor. So I have this old motor out of there. And if you forgot why I'm taking this out, that's because in there should be a fan. Now you can see it. But it's broken more than halfway around. So now it's time for the new motor. This one looks a little bit nicer. Oops, this has attached stuff. So this thing was super hard to take off because the little screw right there definitely had some glue on it. So that's unfortunate, and I thought I was going to strip it out, but I don't think I did. So now I have to put this pinion gear back on the new motor. Got the pinion gear on this new motor, now we have to just install it in there. So it's in. I will adjust this more later on though when I put the diff back in and everything, all this section over here, because then I have to adjust it and get the gear mesh set right with the spur gear. An easy way to set the gear mesh is take the little strip of paper and then stick it in between the two gears, slide the motor over, and make sure that it's in, and then if you can pull the paper out very easily, well, not extremely easily, but with spinning all of it, and then pull on this paper and make it come back out with everything spinning, then it's set right. When you're done setting the mesh, there should be a little bit of wiggle room between the teeth, and then it should spin pretty easily when you spin it. And the reason you have to set that is because if it's too tight, that'll put a lot of stress on the motor and it'll be harder for it to drive. But if it's too loose, then it could either just slip off or start breaking the teeth on the gears. I'm also putting these bigger, stronger drive shafts in because one of these is bent, but I think I'll replace them all. Now I got both of those bigger drive shafts in because these ones don't work very well and they bend pretty easily. So now I just have to put the shocks back on, put the rest of the casing stuff over here, tighten this in, and then head over to the front side. So I got the whole back end done, now I just have to move on to the front. And also, this rear shock shaft is bent, and these two are as well. I just took off this little front bumper piece, and right here doesn't look the best. This looks a little bit bent, and this is not where it's supposed to be, so I don't really know what happened there. Both of these little pins that hold the A-arms on, they're actually both bent pretty bad, so not really sure what to do about that. There we go, got them straightened out a little bit. Now I have to take the diff wrench out of the casing and oil it up. I got the diff housing back on there, and now I have to figure out how to switch out these shocks. There's actually a little screw right here that goes through there, but first it has to go into one of those holes, so I have to remember which one it goes into. Although, on these, this is way too big, so I'll have to figure out how to put those in. Now that they're out, you can really see how bent they are, and it's really crazy, so I definitely need to put the other ones in. So these top little pieces came out just fine, and then I got one of these bottom pieces out, but that's because I had to cut this. But I'm not going to use this because it's bent. This is just going to go in the trash anyway, so perfect. Now these little top pieces don't actually fit in the top of these, so I have to take these little connectors, like I have one in there, and put this screw through there. Then I can attach it up there. There it is. And then take these extra little nuts I found that I have laying around and put those on there. And then it works perfectly. Now these shocks are in. I put these in right there. Got those little tiny screws in, and here I could just put that other nut on the back, put the screw through, and it seems to work good for now. And I thought I had other drive shafts to put in the front, but I don't. So that whole thing was put back together, except for the front bumper there. But, so unfortunately, I had to kind of like hammer these in, the little pins there. It's kind of hard to see them, I don't have my light on right now. And also, I forgot to put the drive shafts in at first, so I tried to take these apart. And these don't come off. I gave it everything that we had. So this, I could move this enough to get the drive shafts out, but it was difficult. So yeah, that's kind of unfortunate. Got all that back on. Now I just need to put this piece on. All of that's together. Now all I have to do yet is put on the new wheels and put the body back on, and then we'll be ready for action. Okay, so I forgot about a couple things. I did remember to put the heatsink on afterwards, and I'm gonna put some Velcro on these batteries and in here to help them stick. Now the Velcro's all on, and in there, I put some hot glue on it and some of this super glue stuff, so who knows how well it'll hold. Like, it might just fall off as soon as I, like, try and pull on it, or it might not even stay on while I'm driving. But we'll test it out. Guys, look at how much better these new wheels look than the old wheels. And the old wheels, there's a bunch of sand in them. You can hear it rolling around. These have so much more grip. They just feel amazing. I can't wait to drive it. Got the wheels on and the battery is Velcroed in, so now I just gotta test it outside. How could I forget about the wing? Okay, this looks epic.
Much nicer, it's so much grippier, you can hear it sometimes, like just when I'm turning corners and everything. And by the way, Landon's here. So yeah, who's faster? 3, 2, 1, go. I think Landon wins.
Yeah, but they're about the same speed.
Oh!